Well, I'm trackside with John Campbell and Dave McGee, and John Campbell's the leading driver because he's won more money, but Dave is the winningest driver in North America. And David, what would you rather have, more wins or all that money?
I guess I'll settle for more wins this year because John's topped me by a big margin in the money.
Now, you know, John, when I look in the paper and I see that you've won $3.6 million or something in purses for the year, a lot of fans may think that you get to take all that money home. Wouldn't that be nice?
It would be nice. I think I'd just work 1 year if that was the case.
Uh-huh. And then retire?
Yeah, I'd just take the rest of my lifetime off.
Uh-huh. But what about being a top driver, and when you look at David and all the wins that he gets and all the money that you guys get in terms of the whole in the industry as a whole, it's got to mean a lot to you to be right there at the top.
Well, it certainly does. I certainly respect anybody that's a leading Dash winner in particular because it takes a tremendous amount of work and way too much work for me to even think about.
No, you were telling me your schedule's winding down and David's is just heating up here.
Well, that's the thing. If you want to win the Dash winning title, you have to work all year, right to the end of the year, because there's going to be somebody chasing you, and that make you sweat.
Now, what about when local out-of-town drivers come in and compete in these big races? Do you feel like you have to be on your best, or do you think differently about competing against out-of-town drivers?
Well, absolutely, you have to be on your best anytime you compete out here, but when guys like John come in, I don't mind a bit. I mean, because he's a high caliber driver and I can trust him out there.
It's fast and fury.
Yeah. I mean, he doesn't do things that aren't really responsible. You know, you can trust him to do the right thing, and it's easier to drive with guys that you can trust than guys that come in that maybe aren't as competent as John.
Well, I think the fans really appreciate 8 skilled drivers and everybody out there on 8 outstanding horses. This is what horse racing is all about. This is what makes it really exciting, these big races like this, isn't it?
Yeah, it sure is. And anytime you put up that kind of money, the drivers are going to want to, or the owners are going to want the best drivers they can get. And you don't have to worry about things going wrong or a driver making a haywire decision in a race like this, like Dave alluded to.
Well, it's a $350,000 purse. If either one of you win this race, what will your share of that purse be, speaking and referring to the money before? What can you make from just one of these drives?
Well, you get 5% of what your horse earns, and if you can win, your horse is going to get $175,000. It's pretty easy to figure out the rest.
So it's going to be a nice night.
Yeah, very nice.
Congratulations, both of you. You're what the sport's all about, and I'm very happy to have you here.
Thank you very much, Ellen.
Thanks.